It's in our nature to protect the ones we love, to stand up to any danger, to be strong and courageous, to always be prepared, to keep our family safe, to be the first line of defense. We are born to protect.
All right, what's up and welcome to the channel. My name is Hagshot and thank you for joining us. And before we get started, if you will, please subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so you know when we're coming out with a brand new video. I also want to thank my patrons. Obviously, you're seeing their names up on here on the screen. These are $5 and up patrons. Thank you so much for your support. Whether you're a viewer here on YouTube, a Patreon, or both, thank you so much. Let's go ahead and get started. Today I'm talking to new gun owners, and this is a very weird time. It has been for almost a year now, but it's an exciting thing when you buy your first gun and you're going to pick that gun up from a gun store and do your background check and all this kind of stuff. And I can't imagine how many gun owners last year, first-time gun owners, went in expecting I'm going to get my ammo, I'm going to take my concealed weapons permit class, I'm going to practice with this, what you should do, I'm going to get really good with this, and I'm going to protect myself. That's a pretty awesome thing when you've taken that step. We did it in 2014, and that's when we started this YouTube channel. And it's an awesome thing. It's a huge learning experience, but it's definitely a beneficial one. But how many gun owners went into their shops last year for the very first time, bought their new gun, and realized, whoa, ammo? $35 a box for 9mm? Like, that sounds pretty expensive. Well, it is. It's about three times the cost of what it was just this time last year. So, you have a lot of different types of shooters. And obviously, you know, we're somebody that we shoot a lot. Even our shooting last year, our range trips, we had to cut down. We had to cut back on ammo. So it, you know, it's just one of those things. It's very expensive. And this is when we came into this in 2014, we were on the end of what had happened in 2012. And, you know, I knew I really wanted to start this channel. And sometimes I would wait in line for an hour and a half at a local store just to be there in time when they got the ammo off of the truck to buy three boxes of ammo. So it can be very tough and it can be very discouraging, but today I'm hopefully gonna give you some tips that will help you so you don't have to use up all your ammo, and just kind of give you my advice on what to do in this type of situation. And it is just my opinion, but again, we've been through this before, and you know, things like this are going to happen again. Unfortunately, this ain't the first time. It's most definitely not the last time. And I don't really involve politics on this channel. I have no interest in doing that because you get enough of that in other places. I kind of want this place to be, our channel to be, a place where politics isn't really involved. It's unfortunate that guns are as politically driven as they are, because in my opinion, it's a pretty apolitical thing. When you think about it, it's a human right. It's an American right to own a gun and have that gun for self-defense. We have a ton of Hispanic, African-Americans, Democrats, whites, blacks, Republicans, independents that watch our channel, and some are patrons. So I see no need in dividing up our awesome community with my political views. But it is a politically driven thing. So what you're going to see probably, I wish this wasn't the case, but over the next 4 years, if there's any mention of gun control, this problem with ammo that we're seeing now is only going to compound on itself. If everything is perfect, let's say we get past COVID and all of that stuff finally is put to rest and people are healthy and everything is safe, then in a perfect world, I would say within a year, you'll start to see things come down. Within two, you'll start to see normal prices once again. So now is not the time to buy a bunch of ammo and try to stock up, because you could see your investment lose 60% of its value in a year or two. Now is the time to just keep a steady, whatever you think your supply should be. Everybody's kind of different. And you know, to enjoy this, you got to have ammo. this gun without ammo is really, it's a paperweight at that point. So here's a couple of things, and here's probably one of the best things that I did when we first got into this, and it's these little things called snap caps. Now, my gun here is clear, of course, and these things right here are chambered, multiple chamberings. I mean, you can get these in rifle calibers, rimfire calibers, pistol rounds like this. And basically the way this works is they're intentionally made to look and feel nothing like a real bullet. Well, you can tell it's much lighter than a real bullet, but you can tell it looks nothing like a real bullet. So obviously we are clear here. So what you do is this kind of allows you to get the function of the firearm and safely do this inside of your home, right? So what you do is you can actually load that into the gun. You can chamber that and you can pull the trigger on it, okay, safely. And then it will extract just or eject just like a normal round, and you can do it all over again. So you may be thinking, well, what's the benefit of this? This is super helpful, not only in learning the action of the gun and how it cycles and things like that, but where I really see it playing into, thank you, Mrs. Hexshot, where I really see it a huge benefit, or I saw it for myself anyways, not only obviously learning how to use the gun, but pick a target on your wall. Maybe while you're watching a TV show, we used to be big time Walking Dead fans, and I'd pick like zombies on the screen or something and just try to bring the gun up, get as clear of a sight picture as you can, and get that trigger pull as straight and cleanly. Just try to pull it back ever so easily. Get it to the point where that front sight pretty much doesn't move. Another good way that you can do this is you can take like an empty casing and put it on the end of the slide here, and you can hold this thing straight out, just as straight as you possibly can. There's no pressure at this point. You know the round's not gonna go off. You know you're really building a lot of great skills here, believe it or not. You're gonna get your sights lined up perfectly, get that trigger pull straight back to the rear, and try to get it where that casing will not fall off of the end of the slide. Obviously, you want to put it where the bullet used to be, kind of turn it upside down, and have the casing just like that on the end of the slide. This is an invaluable tool. They are kind of expensive, but, I mean, you can use them over and over, and you can tell I've definitely used these in the past, and this is a great tool to save yourself on ammo cost and build your skills at the same time. So snap caps are definitely a great investment. Another thing that you can do that's very helpful is if you have a range that rents guns out, a lot of the times that range will have separate range target ammo for just the range. So you can practice and use their ammo without going through your own. So that's another way that you can kind of conserve on your ammo at times like this. Because again, things are 2 and 3 times what they really should be. You know, if you find a good deal, you find a good deal. You definitely want to jump on those when you can. I don't know that hoarding is too much of a problem, as I think it maybe was a bigger problem in 2014, because gun shops seem to have put a limit on what you can buy super quick this time around. So I think it's just a matter. I mean, obviously, it's just supply and demand at this point, and you want to be able to practice. Definitely want to practice, especially if it's a carry gun, home defense gun, those kinds of things. And there are some ways that you can get around this until everything kind of settles out and actually still be able to enjoy this. And again, it's just going to take time to be able to get to that point where everything kind of normals out. Even with us having a YouTube channel and stuff, I refuse to buy ammo at these prices in huge amounts of bulk. I won't do it because I know what it should be. I just kind of keep myself, you know, if you go to the range and you shoot 100 rounds, buy 100 rounds. You know, keep yourself stocked up, you know, whatever that stock may be, just so that way, you know, you have enough to enjoy your gun and still be able to enjoy times like this. There are ways to conserve your ammo. If you have any other tips, make sure you leave them down. We have a lot of new gun owners that watch our channel, and we definitely want to help each other at especially times like this, but all times. But if you have any other ideas for new gun owners, definitely leave them down below. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next one. And as always, hold them down.